got your seal facing in.
Then you install your wings. Do the same thing on the other side. Now that that's on, put a little bit of lubrication
here. In the first part of the inspection shown above, I disassembled a Parker P6 Gold Cup. I had our engineer team come out and came to the conclusion that the creep plate and face plate were worn out, as well as the other typical wearing parts. We always replace the seals and gaskets, so we added that to our parts list.
I'm gonna put them on the cloth there. I'm gonna give it a spin or two just to see how it looks. And I might have to lap it for, you know, 5 seconds. So I'm gonna lap these for a few seconds each. I'm just gonna grab them one by one. You wanna kind of move it, just so it's not, you know, lapping in one surface. So that's my 5 seconds. If it's nice and shiny, that's good. Trying to take that little lip off, but I'm gonna leave it at this for now. Get ready for school. So this is a little tighter. I would pull it off, just mark this one. It would polish me out with a slight burr on it. This seems to be everywhere you put it. Try that. So there's a slight chance that that was our burr. That'd be our second burr right there. I'm just gonna put it in the vise. That way I can turn it without my troubles in turning. That feels a lot better. That surface, use the glass to kind of see where we're at. Now, ideally, you'd want your lines to be perfectly straight and just barely visible. Like, I'm talking maybe magnifying glass, looking at it, trying to see lines would be 100%, but for a repair, to just see the lines without lapping, or without major lapping, is pretty good. Always make sure you put your pins in. See, the shaft is pretty clean. My snap rings in properly. Get this out. My retaining plate. Retaining plate bolts. Shaft seal assembly. And my Nitel washers. Pop my O-ring out. You come over in your literature. This seal right here, A6. And I've got a number 3 shaft. My seal code. So 1 is Buna, 4 is Viton, and 5 is EPR. And you can tell your size. So it's a 043. So I'll find 43, which is right here. That's it. You gotta match up your slot with your piston. Sometimes you have to lift up a little bit, and if you lift up too much, you basically have to start over. So now it's in, but it's not engaged. Now I'm just gonna spin the shaft a little bit. Now it's engaged. My hog shaft didn't drop. I throw the nut on here, so I have something to grab instead of holding on something, and if I, you know, move too much, slip. clip out or cut myself on the case slot. I've done before. Gasket's just like a seal. Always gets replaced. For Teflon seals, obviously new O-rings, new gaskets, all around. So this I already cleaned. Just because this is light, I'm going to try to hand bomb it. I feel like I have a lot more control. And that's it. This, if it's right hand, I want this at 9 o'clock. So how you cut? Brand new. Yep. On these cams, you always want to make sure your threads are up. That way you can always pull your pin out and put a bolt in to take this out. So seal kits for these. There's about 20 seals just in this control. Four in this. I think there's like 15 in here. So that's just three things. And that's already up to almost. So what Willie does, and what Willie showed me to do, you know what step you're at. I just come into my parts list, P15, 129, and 144. So here's my 129, and 144.
I'm still learning the testing of the pumps, so I had Lloyd come over and assist me. After a few adjustments were made on the bench, I had our engineer team come over and make sure the pump ran to the customer's spec. We test so that we know our customer's pump run properly and as it should before we send it back. See the power of testing.